I did the main course called A Fly on the Wall, where we made our own murals, and I decided to do it because I don't consider myself much of an artist, but I really loved the idea behind it and I wanted to be able to get creative and just have fun. So we learned the process of how to create a mural, from designing it to priming the boards, like the process of painting everything. One of the aspects that was interesting about it is that we had a week to finish it all, so there was also the element of figuring out, like, how do you get this done? But what a lot of us ended up doing is if someone finished early, they'd go around and help their friends finishing backgrounds and working on details. And so that collaboration was really awesome, I think, and it helped us bond as a group and also get all the artwork done. And it does feel like everyone's art, like, even though it's individual designs, you did play a role in everyone's creation, and that's super rewarding.
So you're in a Martian habitat?
On Mars.
On Mars.
So our assignment was to create like some sort of net and calculate the dimensions we wanted to use. So we all just had the freedom to create what kind of shape we wanted within like four class minutes.
This one's really cool.
Yeah. How many people we would want to live in if we had to be,
yeah.
If we had to live on Mars? I think we were like, how we were going to do this when we first started, like, introduce the assignment, but today, like,
yeah.
So
cool.
I started water polo probably in like sixth grade. Marin Academy, just kind of, I was drawn to it. I heard that we were getting a brand new aquatic center and I was excited to hopefully play in it, and I got the chance to. We have more than three or four lanes in this pool, which is great. Last year when I played for the Marin Academy team, we had, I think it was four lanes with a shallow end. And now I think we have at least like 9 or 10 lanes without shallow end, which is perfect for running scrimmages. We now get to host our own games. We couldn't host our own games before that. Our JV team and our varsity team, when we're not practicing together, can practice separately in a space that makes room for growth for developing players.
Definitely the highlight for me and my team this year was winning NorCal. We were the first team for the girls to ever win, so that was really exciting and awesome for us.
I think it's just the way we like came together as a community. We are all like really, really good friends and hanging out outside of school and just making sure that everybody on the team feels like included and part of the team, and everyone contributed to like winning our championship.
This year, I'd say, was definitely different than the last few. We had a relatively new team and new coaches. Towards the end of the season, we definitely came together as a team and really united, which really helped us with our success at the end.
I'd say it's just keeping everybody like locked in on what we're trying to accomplish. We made goals at the beginning of the season that we wanted to meet. Winning NorCal was definitely one of them. We made sure and go on our like calendar, which said the date of the championship, and we all said we're going to be there at the start.
As I said, like including all of the underclassmen and creating that team culture, which for MA I feel like is so unique and special, and is part of the reason that we're always so successful, is that our team is able to create such a like family-like bond. I think I really found my place at MA through my experience as a freshman on the soccer team. All the upperclassmen are really inclusive and help you navigate your way through MA, especially at the beginning, and I found that super helpful to find my place.
Yeah, so we're the leaders of the Middle Eastern Student Organization here at MA. It's the newest IDEQ club on campus, and I founded it because I didn't think there was enough representation of Middle Eastern culture here.
Anything you want to add, Malcolm?
And it's non-affinity, so you don't have to be Middle Eastern to experience the fun that we have in store and the events. So we're really excited for this year and trying to level up from last year.
Yeah. We're going to send an all-school email whenever our meetings happen, because we want everybody to come. And because it's non-affinity, that means anybody in the school is welcome to, even if they're not Middle Eastern, just to embrace the culture.
Thank you.
love being able to express myself through movement. I feel like the most rewarding thing has been creating my own choreography and seeing as how I've grown as a choreographer over the course of the past few years. I remember being super nervous at first and not really knowing what to do. But over the years, I've gotten much more comfortable like just dancing in front of my peers, and all of the support that my classmates and the teachers that I've had given me have helped me like grow a lot as a dancer and as an artist in general.
We feel the need to protect, to be someone we're not, to personify the dreams beyond our reach.
There's nothing enlightened about shrinking so that other people won't feel insecure around you.
I have been with Randy Poffy and the Marin Academy Dance Company, gone through Madco 1-2, and I'm now in Madco 3-4. I really like being able to move around as one of my official classes throughout the day and like designated time throughout the week. It's been really rewarding for me. I feel like I've gotten a lot more flexible, and like just the physical benefits are really just substantial. Also just like, you know, for more internally, like I've really like progressed as my role in the dance studio. Through these last 3 years, I've grown to become like a leader and someone who stands in like the front of the class, which is, I really like the confidence it gives me. Randy is incredible, and she helps me develop my ideas and really get to the heart of the emotions and themes I'm trying to convey.
So you can pour out the wine and let me scream at the poor servant girl thinking she was something.
Yes, sir, but I do hope you forgive me.
I'm very glad to know about that, Scapino. But it doesn't happen to be what I'm after at the moment.
Hi everyone, I'm Bryn, and I spent the last 2 years trying to develop a new way to induce limb regeneration in fruit flies, a project in collaboration with Dr. Jessica Whited at Harvard University. I think the most fitting place to start is with, what is regeneration? Most broadly, we're referring to the biological process of restoring missing or damaged stuff. It could be cells, tissue, organs, or entire body parts, depending on the organism. Axolotl salamanders, for one, are renowned for their ability to regrow their limbs, their spinal cord, and even their heart. But actually, all animals can regenerate to some extent. Humans can close wounds with scar tissue and regrow their hair and nails. Some studies have even shown that children under the age of 7 can regrow a severed fingertip. What sets apart the most adept regenerators, however, is their genes. More specifically, how they use certain genes, turning them up or down to activate regeneration processes. By studying axolotls and other regenerators, we hope to learn if or how we could unlock these abilities in humans. Currently, over 2.1 million Americans are living survivors of limb loss. Over the next 25 years, this number is expected to double, and we still don't have any biological therapeutic available as a treatment. In fact, when you Google treatments for limb loss, the top suggestions are acknowledge your feelings and embrace optimism. But we can do better. We can find a treatment and we can help these people. I knew that I wanted my research to contribute directly to this need, so I chose to focus on regeneration induction specifically. That is, trying to provoke limb regeneration in species that, like humans, aren't typically capable. However, in a twisted turn of events, about a whole year into my project, a preprint, meaning preliminary study, so hasn't yet been published, came out disputing the paper that I based my entire project on. After replicating their exact methods of using nutritional supplements, they were unable to find any evidence of leg regeneration in over 1,000 flies. For a few days, I thought my project was over. But I came to realize that actually this controversy makes my project more exciting. I'm now positioned to be the tiebreaker, meaning my results will be exciting either way. Most importantly, my project does not use nutrient supplementation, but a completely different set of methods. Because I'm using different techniques than the ones called into question here, my project is not directly undermined. So, where am I now? After flying back from the fly massacre, I just managed to finish the fly cross and amputations as of today, but at this point I have to wait 3 weeks to allow time to see any regrowth. That means I leave you here. A good old-fashioned cliffhanger. Will it work? Will we see leg regeneration? The answers to these questions are 3 weeks away, because I won't be seeing this through. But whether I see results or not, I will get to tiebreak the contradicting papers I mentioned earlier and weigh in on the question, can we induce limb regeneration in fruit flies? But none of this work would have been possible without the names of everyone on screen. And while I could go on about every one of these people, I want to first thank my mentor, Dr. Whited, for her limitless support of my project, On top of everything else she has going on as a full-time PI and professor, she was always willing to meet with me, talk about my issues, and offer solutions. Thank you so much for all you have invested in me. And finally, an enormous thank you to Amy, without whom the MARC program would not be anywhere near as organized or fun or successful. I'm so grateful to have gotten to work closely with you these past 2 years. Thank you for everything. And with that, are there any questions?
I'm in woodworking with Frank and Ian, which are the math teachers that I've had for this year and last year. So we made skateboards. So I think the hardest part was actually pressing them. So we pressed them in kind of like a vacuum sealed mold in like a bag, which was really hard, mostly because it was really, really fast with like the gluing. We had to glue like all the actual individual pieces together. I think the funnest part has been just like getting to hang out with like all these people who I wouldn't normally see, and getting to hang out with some really, really cool teachers, and just having this experience that we can all share and coming out of it with some really, really cool skateboards.
I really did enjoy it. I think the point of it was to like clean out what makes wildfires more extreme. And the before and after was really crazy. In the process, it was really tiring, but after the success, it was really cool.
Our club name is GeoGuessr Club, which is essentially a game. It's like an online game where you're placed in a random Google Maps street view location, and you have to figure out where you are, mark it on the map. You try and get as close as possible, basically. Yeah. And then we just like play that for fun.
We hope to increase Marin Academy's worldwide knowledge through this simple game of GeoGuessr.
We're currently taking a lot of recommendations. We're probably not going to read full books, but like print out chapters, I guess. We were going to focus on women experiences, particularly in like the 1900s and stuff. We were collecting like a list of everyone's interests, and it seems like to be a variety, so we'll go off that.
In Garden Club, we're gardening for food security in Marin, and we're going to be going down to an elementary school once a month to work in their garden, since they give so much back to the community.
Yeah, and that'll be like after school and stuff, yeah.
Echoes is MA's literary magazine and writing club, and we're planning to do a bunch of fun activities this year, writing workshops, we're going to talk to authors, and we're going to put together a great magazine in the spring.
We're looking forward to having a lot of really fun activities that allow people who are writing to come together, but also some serious activities that allow people to learn and grow in their writing, and creating a community of people who really enjoy writing, reading, doing art, just bringing people together.
Starting the Design Lab Club to really just get more participation in the Design Lab, because I feel like a lot of students never experience the Design Lab and never go in it. So we just really want to do some fun projects. Like we have a rug tufting that we're doing, and we're doing just a bunch of fun kind of projects that people can sign up for to come get some experience in the Design Lab.
I've always wanted to dance and I've always enjoyed it, but I never thought about actually taking it until this year. So I decided to take a leap and join the Taiko class.
I'm used to performing, but I've never performed in front of a school or a school event like this, so it was a really nice experience, especially doing a style of dance I've never done, like taiko.
I enjoy being able to be physical in the morning, and it's nice to start the day off with some activity. I like how it's taught me principles of like consistency and effort. This is actually the first time performing in front of an audience, so I've learned how to deal with like my nervousness and that as well.
The most rewarding is seeing every other day our A block like improve week after week, day after day, learning new rhythms and learning new beats while working with different drums, and it is very cool to see everyone grow.
Galen is a really great teacher. He's been really nice. I think the performance was really rewarding for me. It was nice to see all of us. I think we felt really great during the performance. I think we all felt proud of ourselves, and it was nice to see all of our hard work come to fruition.
Thank you.
one. Rioja. I presume 15 years, clearly. From Tempranillo grapes with it's a pretty soft and oaky and the oak finish is long and deep. Oh, this reminds me of the time Nicolette and I sat under my grandmother's oak, playing with a termite's nest. Well, we managed to kill them off with a hose and cleaning supplies. Well, we just thought they were ants, but I guess we saved the house. and that's when my grandmother gave me my first bottle of wine. I feel like I am inherently a problem solver even when I don't know what the problem is in the first place. Oh, now I can sense the Rioja should have aged a couple of more months. Primitivo. Well, this one's younger, and I mean, you can almost taste southern Italy, specifically Palermo. Oh, and the raisins are much stronger in this than the cherries, black cherries. Oh, how I enjoyed Palermo. I spent a summer there refining my palate, and afterwards I had to go back to Princeton to finish my Italian major degree. Oh, I hated New Jersey. There were just no rolling hills with beautiful grasses and supple Italian poppies. I'm good for now. Thank you. And I'm really looking forward to this reunion and dinner. I think it's a really, really good idea. I mean, the eight of us, we haven't seen each other in such a long time, 20 years. And well, we basically love each other. Well, maybe Reggie and I would argue about something on occasion, but we are a family. A family of misfits, yes, but a family.
First course, bon appetit.
Wow. Oh man, this shrimp reminds me of how many Jamamani used to make. Still remember the night Dad took us to kill him. Things were simple back then. Of course, some things never change.
I remember back then, we used to do hits all the time, but nothing was quite like the first one. Tomini Jamamani. Oh, he was a real gangster, that Tommy. I remember we had to go through about 24 guards just to get to him.
Oh, you've counted wrong. It was all 36 of them.
Oh, what?
Cop took us to make sure we didn't get ourselves killed. He gave Enzo away the sniper. He trusted him to kill and blow. What difference does it make? It never matches accuracy.
But Pop didn't even let me into the building. He gave Viola here the machine gun. Let him have the fun job. While I was out on the cold roof waiting for the signal, Viola was inside slaughtering. That is, until things went south.
Because, you see, there was a rat among us. Tommy knew about the hit well before we even got in the building. Yes, he was wearing a bulletproof vest when we got in his office. Enzo here had a perfect shot, no surprise, with a bullet just pathetically coming to the floor. I should have realized right then and there what was happening. But before I could even raise my gun, I heard another shot, bang! Tomedy fell to the floor, bullet straight between the eyes. Of course Enzo could have died shot in seconds. I could have assessed the situation as fast as he could.
We thought it was over then, but it turns out Tomedy had one last trick up his sleeve. As Pop and Viola approached his desk, I noticed something was off. You see, Tomedy had hidden a landmine underneath his chair. I tried to call out to them, but it was no use. Viola had seen it first. Pop was this close from getting blown to Kingdom Come, but Viola pulled him back. A real hero. But that's just how things were back then.
I'm sick of living in Enzo's shadow. Heard of mobs and stuff, but never made it easy on me. Even the house was a struggle.
Viola always had to have the spotlight. I hate him! I hate his guts! Our whole lives, he's always been ahead. Even from the day we were born. Because Mom always loved him more.
Oh, what adventures. Oh, how adorable. Bang, bang. Would like to share a little something about their lives over the past 1 year.
I can.
You know, people think that being in the fashion business is all about making people look and feel good, but if I'm honest, I only really do it for the money. I knew I had a talent for sales when I saw how successful my locker shop became in high school, and I figured that selling clothes would be my best bet at making the most money I could, because people pay the most ridiculous prices for clothes. Like, that coat I had on, $25,000. I would have to sell, like, a million bags of chips in order to make that much. But hey, I did work really hard to get where I am. And now I live in an amazing house with everything I could ever want. But in interviews, people talk about my determination and how great it must feel to be so successful, and go tell them about my struggles, but it doesn't really matter to me. I never wanted the admiration of others. I didn't care about it. I just liked the money. And also, I just want to say that I think that anyone who says, oh, money can't buy happiness, they just don't have enough money.
Wow, Nicolette, I just appreciate your unapologetic consumers. Oh, material girl.
Course that I am taking is build a guitar. I chose to build a bass, and basically we bought these guitar kits from Build Your Own Guitar Kits, and we got to choose which bass and guitar we did, so I chose a P bass. I've always wanted to build like my own instrument, and so this mini course really helped me gain knowledge in like woodworking and painting and staining, and so John's a great teacher, actually. I have him as my electrical engineering and computer science teacher. He's just a great and fun teacher in general. He's such a great person to hang around and gives great advice.
Buenas, soy Pablo Dinámico de Cuba. Llegué hace un año y medio a Estados Unidos. Soy profesor de baile, salsa, bachata, reggaetón, muchas cosas. Hoy le estaba dando clases aquí en la escuela, gracias a la profesora Gaby, a la escuela por invitarme. Hoy estuvimos enseñando salsa cubana y un poco de reggaetón. La salsa cubana es diferente a la salsa de Nueva York. La salsa de Nueva York se baila en línea. Hoy di la salsa cubana, que se baila más movido por el escenario, por la escena. Los estudiantes, por ser primera vez, lo están haciendo muy bien. Lo importante es que ellos se diviertan. Pero aparte que se divirtieron, vi mucho que tienen talento para bailar. Hay muchos que tienen talento para bailar y que les gusta. Principalmente es que a ellos les gusta, les gustó. Ellos se la pasaron muy bien y les gustó. Entonces ellos bailan bien. Hay algunos que tienen talento para bailar.
Okay, so our club is Surfrider Foundation, and Surfrider focuses all on everything California coast, and it's actually across the nation too, but we do fundraisers, we do informational meetings, and we focus a lot, we test for water quality through Blue Water Task Force, and at MA we run samples and upload it to a database, and so they can track the water quality around the Bay Area.
We also help to organize beach cleanups to do some active participation in helping clean up our beaches.
And I'd say the coolest thing about Surfrider Club is that there's other student organizations for Surfrider around California, so we can work with other schools in Marin that also have Surfrider chapters and really like get involved.
And last year we raised over $2,000 in our t-shirt fundraiser. And yeah, super fun. We love it. Thank you.